Yo, what's going on, guys, and welcome back to the FIFA 20 Sunderland career mode. So, in the last one, at the end of the episode, I said I'd show you a couple of transfer targets that I'm after. Yeah, didn't happen. So I'm going to do it in the start of this episode. But yeah, I want to just quickly show you the table to start the things off. We have a game against Swansea at home at the Stadium of Light. I'm not quite sure where they are on the table. Let's have a quick look. They're 16th. Okay, so they haven't had the best starts of the two this season. They've played three, drew three. We, however, have played the same amount of games, but we've won one more game than they have. We've won two games, sorry, and drew one. So we have four more points than they do. So we are obviously having a better start to the season. Again, the second season is really, really interesting because obviously we've got the Europa League coming up. We also have Watford and Bournemouth and Crystal Palace, all Premier League teams currently in real life, and they will be battling it out for top spot slash automatic promotion. So we're going to have a bit of competition this season with those. I'm pretty sure they've still got their original teams as well. If not, they'll have a couple of changes, obviously, from being dropped down in the Championship. But apart from that, they will probably have more or less the same squad. So yeah, let's get into those transfer targets. And the first transfer target is Jamal Blackman, the English 26-year-old keeper, originally from Chelsea. Moved to Vitesse last season, or this season in real life, in the summer. So yeah, he's 6'6", so he's got a long reach. He's actually a pretty decent keeper. I think his potential's like 81, 82. So he's going to be a decent keeper going forward, especially once we get into the Prem, at least for our first season in the Prem. Hopefully that's in our third season, if things can go in the way they are. So yeah, Jamal Blackman is going to be our long-term replacement, or medium-term replacement for John McLaughlin. So I'm going to try and make that transfer happen now. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen. Jamal Blackman is now officially part of the squad. He has a contract length of 3 years, £6,800 a week, and a squad role of rotation. If we just have a look at his actual contract, it says he's got contract length of 4 years there, but it's clearly a three-year contract. Right, okay, FIFA, whatever. But yeah, honestly, I don't give a shit. We've got our keeper. We've got the one we wanted. He has a clean sheet bonus of 15 for £1,250. Whatever. You know, I'm not bothered about additional fees because they're that small. They're not really going to impact our budget much. It's just inconsequential, insignificant, whatever. But yeah, we have this now. So we shall jump into the second transfer target that I'm going to go after. Transfer target number two is Karamoko Dembele. Ladies and gentlemen, if you know your youngsters, your upcoming wonder kids, you will recognize this boy. He has 4-star skills, 4-star weak foot. He is 5'3", obviously he's just a kid. He's 16 in real life right now, but obviously 17 on the game because, you know, season two. But yeah, he's high, low. His preferred foot is obviously right, but that 4-star weak foot is beautiful. Basically, I'm looking at Karamoko Dembele as a replacement for Duncan Watmore. So I'm slowly rotating the original players out and bringing new players in. And Karamoko Dembele looks an absolute, like, he's just a gem. He's literally just a gem. So yeah, we're going to go ahead and make a transfer offer for Karamoko Dembele. I will complete the deal, just get it out the way, because FIFA's doing that thing again where it's glitching. But yeah, I'll get the deal out the way, I'll get all that sorted, and we should be good. Alright, so I couldn't secure Karamoko Dembele for some reason. It wouldn't let me negotiate his contract for some reason. So I'm going to try, I've just retracted the offer, and I'm going to redo the offer in exactly 1 week. I offered, what was it? I think I offered £3 million and Celtic accepted it. But when it came, like I say, when it came to negotiating the contract, it was just like, nope, can't do this, sorry. So I don't know what's going on there. But again, I'll try again in like the 26th of August in game and see what happens. But anyway, jumping into the Swansea game, we have the rotation team, and Jeremy Frimpong starts, Brandon Williams starts, obviously Embleton and Samut in there in the centre midfield. So I'm looking forward to seeing how this team plays in a proper actual competitive game, because I don't think I've used it yet with the new signings in a competitive match. So hopefully they're up for the task. Swansea coming forward. So they play it back. Why are you playing it back? All you had to do was run at my defence. But then again, I am playing drop back. So do what you want. Oh, well, then Kyle Norton. Do what you have to. Andre, are you? Big Roy Carroll. Let's go. Let's not. That happened. That actually happened. All right, so we've conceded. Wasn't expecting them to be on the front foot from the beginning. Obviously, Embleton being dispossessed led to this guy scoring. Yeah, you know what? We're just gonna. It's still nil nil. It's still nil nil. What do you mean? Ruben Samud. Williams. Inside to Embleton. Kim Yorga, good fake shot. That's not who I wanted that to. That's a pen. I'll take that. I wanted that just flicked back to I think that was Embleton coming in, or might have been Frimpong. But it's a foul nonetheless, and it's a penalty. So Duncan Watmore steps up to take it. Into the top bins. Boom. Well, it's not top bins. It isn't top bins at all, but it is 1-1. Solid pen from Duncan Watmore. Again, like I say, I wanted that back heel. I don't know who that was. I'm gonna actually have a look at the instant replay just to see who was coming in. Get away from the referee. So Kim Yorker gets the ball here, and I just want him to like roll it back, which he does. It is. It's Jeremy Frimpong who I wanted that to go to, because what I wanted to happen was Kim Yorker to just gently roll that back, Frimpong to take a touch and just smash it towards that far corner. But it goes to who is that? Elliot Embleton? Yeah, that's Embleton there coming in, who wins the ball and is obviously fouled. But that's 1-1. Kim Bioga picks up the ball from Frimpong, and he's just going to run into this space. I mean, that's exactly what we are after. Aaron Connolly in the middle. It's a free header. Aaron Connolly, what are you doing, my guy? All you had to do was keep that down, man. All you had to do was keep that down. Ruben Smooth picks the ball up. Duncan Watmore. Into Connolly. Spins his man. Aaron Connolly, get your shot off. Too late. Alright, 10 minutes of the game left to go, and I'm bringing on the big guns. Luciano Acosta and Greenwood coming on for Watmore and Connolly. I really need to get a goal. And I've also dropped that blind because I'm legit being blinded by the sun. So, hopefully, we can do something. Acosta into Gooch. I see you, Greenwood. Mason Greenwood! He's onside! He's onside! They've legit. Acosta and Greenwood have been on the pitch less than 2 minutes, and they've already contributed. They've already contributed. Mason Greenwood through the legs of the keeper. Keeper with a mug banner. We celebrate, the stadium erupts, and it is 2-1 coming in from, well, we've come from behind. We've legit managed to come from behind. All right, guys, and your man of the match was Lyndon Gooch with a 9 rating. Mason Greenwood there with an 8.6. He come on the field, scores a goal. Instant hero. Duncan Watmore there, 8.7. But yeah, Lyndon Gooch being your man of the match. And an interesting development, ladies and gentlemen. Ajax have come in, and they're interested in purchasing Lyndon Gooch. Now, Lyndon Gooch's value, obviously, with the Realism mod, is £26 million. Given transfer values are based on performance as well as age and potential. And obviously, with dynamic potential being a thing, then obviously Gooch's potential has probably increased since we started this career save. So, £26.3 million is quite a lot of money for Lyndon Gooch, especially when I can replace him with Karamoko Dembele, provided I can get my hands on him. This is a really, really good transfer. This is the thing. Have we got anyone in the squad that can fill in just in case? No. Grr. Alright, well, we technically, yes, we could swap Watmore out to the wing and bring Dobson in as a cam. if necessary, but 26 million for Lyndon Gooch is a lot. That this is what I'm saying. 26 million for Gooch is a lot of money. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and the first sim game of the episode. It is against Shrewsbury Town, who are roughly bottom or in the bottom three, having lost all of their games so far. So we're going to go ahead and advance. And it is a 3-1 victory. Kim Bjorka with two goals and Watmore with the other. We did concede. So they equalised when we went 1-1. And then Kim Bjorka come in with a brace. All right, decent. And round two of the Carabao Cup, and this is why I simmed the Shrewsbury game. So we have Liverpool. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going with the first team. Timothy Ioma gets a start. Junior Malanda is back from his suspension, so he fits straight back into the centre of midfield alongside Bali Mumba. Again, this is our strongest lineup. Jamal Blackman gets his debut. I'm hoping that he performs very, very well and manages to keep a clean sheet. Hopefully, we can get Liverpool on the counter-attack. Basically, our plan for this match is to sit back, absorb the pressure, and catch them on the counter. That is why we have Onuma, Amuzu, Greenwood, and Acosta going forward. Hopefully, the six defensive players, Hume, Ioma, Willis, Onine, Mumba, and Malanda, can sustain the Liverpool pressure that we are bound to get. Plus, they're bound to play a strong team anyway. So, hopefully, this is one of those games that we can just nab a winner. I mean, saying that, I'm pretty sure the last time we played Liverpool in this career mode was last season. And I'm pretty sure we beat them 2-0. So I'm going to check the Liverpool side just to be on the safe side. Yeah, it's a full strength side. Well, I say a full strength. They've got Marco Grujic and Nathaniel Klein there. But apart from that, it's strong. It's Alisson, it's Robertson, it's Van Dijk, it's Romagnoli. Wijnaldum there, Henderson, Firmino, Salamone. So yeah, that's what you expect. Amuzu running at Henderson straight away off the bat. Acosta's coming in. Ooh. 2 minutes into the game and we've already had our first chance. I think Amuzu might be our secret weapon here against Liverpool. Sadio Mane gives it back to Henderson, flicks it forward for Firmino. Firmino's got quite a lot of space, actually. He's beaten Malanda. Wijnaldum's running through. Good hands by Blackman. Mumba. Amuzu. Mumba gets a lucky bounce. Greenwood slips it through. Sweaty goal. Luciano Costa 1-0. I really don't care. I really don't care. Sweaty goal. I will sweat if I have to win this game. Our pace up top, the pace of the front four is just so incredible. Liverpool cannot handle us. Liverpool cannot handle us. So, yeah, good counter-attack there by Amuzu. Again, lucky bounce by Mumba to feed through into Greenwood. And obviously, Greenwood into Acosta. And you know what happens then. Klein. Back to Salah. I'm watching you, Wijnaldum. Into Firmino. I don't like 1-0 leads. That was really, really close. I think that was Malanda coming in. If Malanda hadn't, or that might have been Ioma. Either way, whoever put that tackle in managed to put Firmino off his shot. Acosta. Why is the first touch in this game so bad? Henderson, Firmino. Oh, why is the first touch so bad in this game, bro? I've noticed that this match, like, a couple of my players are making really bad first touch like that. Why? What is that for first touch? Unnecessary danger. Ah! Get it away. Unnecessary danger. The referee has indicated there will be a minimum of 3 minutes. Acosta. That's not the ball I wanted. That is Onuma 2-0. Oh, Jesus. That was stress. The game, you're not doing passes in the direction I'm telling you to. And it's really, really annoying. Like, this pass here, right, shouldn't have gone there. It should have gone more central for Greenwood to run onto. But Greenwood still manages to get his foot to the ball. He manages to feed it to Onuma. It's another sweaty goal, but Onuma in the right place at the right time, 2-0. All right, second half, ladies and gentlemen, and obviously it was a very lively first half, so I'm expecting the second half to be the same. Francis Amuzu straight through again with a cross into the back post. It's a Costa, and it's a fantastic save by Alisson. Hume down the line for Malanda. Over the top, Josh Onuma. Mumba with... somehow still has the ball. Mumba with... oh, I thought he would have got a third attempt there. He got two bites to the cherry and he still couldn't put it in the net. Again, like I say, Liverpool just don't know what to do with us. Junior Malanda. Boom. Straight through for Luciano Acosta, who sees Mason Greenwood, and it's three. It's a clinical finish from Mason Greenwood. He finally gets himself on the score sheet. No, wait. Didn't he score the first one? I don't know. There's a lot has happened in this match, and I can't remember who scored the first goal. Either way. No, it was Acosta. Acosta got the first one. Greenwood got the third one, and Onuma got this one. Yeah, so Amuzu is the only one out of the front four that doesn't have a goal yet. But, yeah, just... R.I.P. Liverpool, man. Mane and Henderson linking up down here on this left-hand side. Nathaniel Clyne now feeds it into Sadio Mane. Mane's not exactly going anywhere, and that is full-time. So 3-0 victory against Liverpool in the Carabao Cup. Bear in mind, like I say, this is one difficulty less than Ultimate. We're already on Legendary. Like, if we take it up to Ultimate, then... I don't know. We can't go any higher. This is the thing. So we just pulled off a fantastic victory. We shut Liverpool out. We absorbed the pressure and caught them on the counterattack. Perfect tactics. I said exactly what would happen. Anyway, man of the match. Mason Greenwood, 9.5 rating. Luciano Costa, 9.3. Onuma and Amuzu on 8.5. No substitutes used in this game. But Jamal Blackman on his debut against a Premier League team of all teams to play against, Liverpool as well. He managed to keep a clean sheet. What a guy. What a performance. All right, guys, and Karamoko Dembele is now officially part of the club. So, yeah, he's 74 rated. He has a squad role of sporadic for some strange reason. That's what he wanted. 4-year contract, signing bonus of 1 million with a weekly wage of 4,000 and no more performance bonuses. So, yeah, Karamoko Dembele will come in and slot in for Duncan Watmore, who will now vacate the space in the rotation team. Alright guys, and the first of two sim games now to close off the episode. So yeah, Derby at home in the championship. We're going with the rotation team. Karamoko Dembele is technically that this is his debut, so we're going to go ahead and skip. And it's a 2-2 draw. Right. Kimpioga with another brace. Kimpioga loves scoring them goals, boys. He's MVP of the series. What do you mean? But yeah, Quintilla there and Marriott getting Derby's goals as well. Kimpioga being a hero and leveling and basically equalizing twice in the team. So yeah, Karamoko Dembele there getting a draw on his technically his debut. All right guys, and the last sim game of the episode just to round this off. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and accept and skip. It's a 1-1 draw. Luciano Acosta getting the goal and Luka Milivojević getting Palace's goal. So yeah, as you can see, are you Maya Milivojević, Van Aanholt still there? They've pretty much got the same side. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and I realized that I needed to complete a season objective, otherwise I was close to being sacked. So I've gone ahead and completed the transfer of Adnan Yanatay. He was on loan at Sunderland about 4 years ago from Manchester United before he went to Real Sociedad. Now he's a right wing, left wing. He's the same age as Lyndon Gooch. He's also, you know, really like, he's a much better player than Lyndon Gooch. Obviously, in real life. Yeah, okay. But yeah, anyway, in the game, stat-wise, attribute-wise, he is a much better player than Lyndon Gooch. So obviously, he's going to come in. He'll probably go straight into the first team, believe it or not, and Onuma will drop down at the rotation team. But yeah, Yanatay is approximately 77, 78 rated that I do know of. Obviously, second season, he may have gone up. I do not know. But yeah, I've offered him £50,000 a week. He gladly accepted that. Obviously, he's got a £1 million signing bonus. He wanted crucial and 3 years, which I was happy with. So yeah, that is basically what has just happened. That is just what's transpired over this episode. So at the end of this episode, ladies and gentlemen, we are comfortably, well, it's comfortably. I like saying comfortably, I don't know why. But yeah, we are sitting fourth in the championship. Obviously, Crystal Palace, Bournemouth and Charlton ahead of us. But to be perfectly honest, we aren't playing that bad. We aren't playing that bad at all. We have a goal difference of 7. It looks like Watford there and Nottingham Forest. Obviously, we are ahead of Watford on alphabetical order, given that goal difference is exactly the same as well as our points. But yeah, we're ahead of Watford in that respect. So we could have technically been fifth this episode had it been a different team below us in the alphabet. But nope, we are perfectly fourth. So yeah, we're in the playoff place at the moment after 7 games played. We are aiming for at least automatic promotion this season. Again, we have Watford, we have Crystal Palace, and we have Bournemouth to contend with this season. So we have some challenge this season in order to get automatic promotion back into the Premier League. Don't forget that our Europa League, the Europa League will eventually start at some point. Probably next episode or the episode after is when the Europa League will start. And this is our group. So we have Sporting, CP, again, strong team. Slava Prague there and BSC Young Boys. So the Swiss team, Slava Prague, the Czech team, and obviously the Portuguese team, Sporting CP, there as well. To be perfectly honest, that is a strong group. That is a really strong group. If you just have a look at the other groups as well, Lille should top their group there. Atalanta, yeah. Papu Gomez, yeah. So Atalanta should top their group as well. Arsenal, ooh, that is decent. That is a hefty group. Arsenal, Marseille, Celtic, and Helsinki, yo. That could be difficult for people to contend with, to be perfectly honest with you guys. So Group E here, Rangers, Porto. So Porto should top their group as well. Galatasaray there, mixed in with Salzburg and Real Betis. I would imagine Betis and Salzburg going through there. Group G there, Roma should top their group. Group H, probably Villarreal or Besiktas to top their group. Standard Liège isn't a bad team either, to be fair, so Standard Liège could do bits as well. Group I, Ajax there, Antwerp, Mons, Sion. So yeah, we could have Ajax there topping their group. Group J, Leicester alongside AZ Alkmaar and the other two teams in that group. Leicester should top their group, no problem. Obviously, Group K, Sevilla, Werder Bremen, Athens and Molde. Against Sevilla, Werder Bremen to go through that group. And Group L is Milan, Dynamo Zagreb, Feyenoord and Wolfsburg. Okay, Wolfsburg, I should say. But yeah, Feyenoord, Zagreb and Milan will be fighting it out for the top two spots. But I predict Milan and Dynamo Zagreb to get out of their group. So we are, obviously, we are Group A. We are looking at that group. And our probably looking at Sporting CP to be our contenders for top spot in that group. The way we've just played though against Liverpool in this episode, we should actually manage to get out of the group into the knockout stages, and that's what our target is for this season. If we quickly have a look at the Champions League though, Bayern, Valencia, Benfica and Malmo there in Group A. Group B, Juventus, Dortmund, PSV and Basel. Group C, Barca, United, Olympic, Lyon and Copenhagen. Damn, that is a good group. That is a strong group. Group D there, Paris, Atletico Madrid, Leipzig and Moscow. Yo, Group D is strong. Group E, Liverpool, Napoli, Dynamo, Kiev and Fenerbahce. So strong competition there for Liverpool. In Group F, Chelsea, Inter Milan, Lokomotiv Moscow and Ghent. Chelsea and Inter should top their groups respectively. Group G is Manchester City, Bayer Leverkusen, Lazio and Sparta Prague. Again, Leverkusen and City should go through in that group. Group H, the final group is Real Madrid, Tottenham Hotspur, AS Monaco and Spartak Moscow, which is a really strong group, believe it or not. You wouldn't look at it on paper, it wouldn't look like it, but it is a really, really tough group, that Group H there. So Real Madrid and Spurs to go through out of that group. So with that being said, we've ran through the Champions League and the Europa League groups. Obviously, like I said, we're in the Europa League, so we're focusing on that this season. If we can get into the knockout stages, I'll be happy. And obviously, I'm primarily going to be focusing on the Championship, getting into that second place minimum. That is our target this season. We have to reach second place in the table. So thank you so very much for watching, guys. If you have enjoyed this episode, drop a thumbs up. It would be greatly appreciated. If you are new around here, hit that big red button underneath the video. It would massively help me out. Hit the notifications bell as well so you get notified when I go live and release other videos. Like I say, guys, thanks for watching, and it's greatly appreciated. I'll catch you in a bit.